faulty. The motor control system is malfunctioning. Please consult the service. Wow. You are currently driving the absolute most exclusive SUV right now, aren't you? Yes.
I absolutely must sell the Ferrari. What do you mean exactly that I absolutely must sell the Ferrari? I am planning to sell the Ferrari today, and we've already got everything perfectly prepared. Look over here, collector's set, bam, comes with everything, everything, this is included, that's part of it, everything is included. Yes, the time has finally come. Indeed, we're in deep cleanup mode now, and the car, well, I definitely won't be taking it anymore since time has completely run out. And that's exactly why we're heading over to our dear grandma's place today, and I'll demonstrate how I manage this. When I want to sell a car. The thing is, we've talked before, and I have to say, Omid threw a price of 210,000 euros at me. For the car, we're completely transparent, and it's actually a very fair rate. I think the cheapest online is around 239 or something. Yeah, maybe we could even get out 5 million or so. And for that, you definitely need something, a few gifts for starters to break the ice a bit. We're about to choose that right now, but I already have the perfect thing, namely. Well, if that doesn't look really good in his dealership, then I genuinely don't know what does. A very, very classy room fragrance. So we're going to take a few last videos now. Today, by the way, is the first day of Ramadan. And I say for me, Ramadan is always a very beautiful time because it allows one to really focus on what's essential. Actually, I'm funny. It's just that in general, everyone's a bit quieter. That's all. What do you guys actually think about this iced out thing? Well, I must say, it has gotten a bit quieter lately. But last year I experienced it too. In the summer it picked up again. Here we have a Cartier. Generally, I find Cartier watches much better than the Datejust models because they simply sparkle more. Though, you can't really see it here. You always have to work with a bit of blur. Can I manage this now? Can I do it? I can't do it like this now. Well, I think you know what I mean, but let me know, is iced out still a thing, or would you say no, it's not a thing anymore? Actually, I'm asking the right folks here on YouTube. Hey, there's something I gotta say. In that highlight channel video, we reacted to the great Leon. And you guys have actually written some truly weird stuff in those comments. You really threw shade there. I mean, the seller, I didn't find him unlikable, actually. And you threw quite a bit of shade, which really wasn't very nice at all. I mean, saying things like Leon being so incredibly unlikable and all that. Honestly, I have to say, it's manageable. Sometimes I feel like the YouTube comments have become super toxic. I don't even know why. There's so much hate being spread. Why? I don't understand. As seen, what happened with the gold price is madness, how the price jumped around there. This month, we have successfully achieved an extremely high turnover with precious metal. I've checked it now. That's sort of our entry-level product. Here's a single 1 gram piece. A 1G bar, meticulously all made and designed by Filoro. For those who are curious and pondering why the gold market price is where it is, why it roughly costs so much,
65 euros. That's about 78 euros.
Why is that 12 euros more? It's because we pay manufacturing costs. That means, of course, the cost of plagues and the total comes to about. Then you can calculate for yourselves what we make on it. Just a nice product for someone who's touching precious metal for the first time. Now you can check if it's for you. And setting aside a bit of gold is never a bad idea. Bad news, we're still here because the car was out of gas. Now we're leaving on Wednesday. A new day begins. An update on our dear colleague, somehow. I haven't fully gone through the message yet. Wrote something. I haven't read it all, but he certainly mentioned that Bago has nothing to do with this matter.
Bago has also...
I too came across a post on Instagram indicating that he doesn't even know the guy at all.
Man, how messed up can one be?
What's this exactly? The employee is just sitting there, completely lost in daydreaming. He mentioned that person is indeed his very best friend. Or, well, not or, but he meant there were three of us in the room. So it wasn't just me, we were four in the room. I didn't make this up now.
People are unfathomable.
Today, my good friend Aaron will be making his way over here to visit. He's actually one of the very last ones from our group to do so. It's about us simply visiting each other at home, seeing how we live, and see if we can pick up a thing or two, and Victoria comes back. Of course, I'm really looking forward to that too. We've got to repack, folks. So today is the last Saturday we're in the store. Tomorrow is Sunday, and that means packing day is tomorrow. Then comes Monday. On Monday, we've got some things to sort out with the ERP system as well.
And then, my dear folks, Tuesday is departure day. We'll be leaving at night.
Taking off, setting off, and yes, now, in these last few days. I arrive and then still doubts creep in. I could have had such a lovely life here. I could have just stayed here. Right now it's going well with the company too. We're achieving the best sales results we've ever seen, really. Everything's running more or less quite smoothly now. Of course, we have many problems too. There are always new issues cropping up as we grow and so on. But I could have just stayed here. Look, this is my spot. This could be my place, where I am just every day. I also know it's odd that I talk this way because I always want to... I'll just keep doing more and stuff, but right now it's kind of, there's no turning back anyway, but maybe you know what it's like when you've made a decision and then you think about starting the work, kind of like that, you know. And that's how it is. But life goes on. In 6 months or so, the world will look different again. Or maybe I'll end up over there. I've only got myself to blame. So, my dear folks, this is indeed our final evening here. We're totally done. I must say, today was really, truly tough. When the cats were picked up and all, no matter what actions you might take, it's always the last time. And yes, indeed, the time has finally come. We're not taking anything at all from the office. Yes, everything stays right here. And then next month, at some undetermined point, I absolutely plan to come back here for a whole week. Yes, that's how it looks. You always ask yourself these questions. Will you do it again? Or was that the right decision? Honestly, I've genuinely shed quite a few tears earlier today, but really, what else can I possibly do? It's just how it is. It's inside of me. I can't help it. Inside me, it's just simple. I have to do this. I can really understand why not many people do this. To be so utterly and completely bananas, giving up all of this comfort. For so very many problems, all the issues we have. But if there's one thing I've learned, something you can definitely remember whenever it gets uncomfortable, that's precisely where you should go. So whenever I did things that were uncomfortable and went through with them, the benefit afterwards was very, very significant. So whether it's about traveling or anything else, so whenever I said like, wow, no way, and all that stuff, then it was always the right path. Oh man, guys, that essentially means we will have to get ourselves up at 5 a.m. and then we're off on our exciting adventure. Oh yes. Well, we'll hopefully get to the first stream right away. I need to do the first stream promptly to maintain some consistency. Otherwise, it would feel like everything's falling apart. Then I'd go crazy, so the stream will also be coming up promptly. Good night, everyone. See you in a bit. Got to be quiet. The kid is sleeping. Here we approach Omid, who's on the run, spilling secrets.
We have actually got some very brand new testers on board with us today, believe it or not.
Let's take a look. So we're currently working on quite a few different buffers. This one right here is, okay, please watch this closely now. So right here, this is the molecular scent, which as it turns out is supposed to be very expensive indeed. Molecular scent variation. This is, I don't know, we'll have to look it up in a moment. This one is also, I don't know. So this is, why is this back again? Ah, 35%, okay then. This here is called the private garden. It's quite smoky, very smoky, okay? This is indeed the one, and this is in fact also private garden once again. So, and right here we have a sensor in, oh, it's getting hot now, folks. And actually this is what I always wait for. Very, 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 very long. Now, here's the key part. This is always the moment of truth. You have many creative ideas swirling around in your head. You pass them on to others, but whether it fully works or not, with our new Vendetta perfume, there is now an extra layer with an added distinct smoky note to it.
That's 35, 35, the same one twice. Let's see. Yes, the same one twice. Okay.
Yes, because otherwise it's constant correction, constant correction. I think this might work. Oh, interesting. He's lowered the dosage. Last time it was far too intense for me. It was overly resinous in taste. Now it's already different. Man, that's a masculine scent, seriously. It's milder here. This is the version without smokiness. What do you say? Yeah, do you like it or is it generally...
Do you like it? And I think the one. With the smoky, I prefer it. Though I'd almost say you might like smoky just a few percent less.
Even less?
Even less. But if you take a look, you really can smell it right away, can't you now?
Pretty strong, yes. There's something else I meant to tell you. I actually told you. To mix in some saffron. Well, that's a pity. So then on to the final correction stage. Private garden. That's the final stage. Private garden. Yes, it's approved. It's approved. Lovely apple scent. Very clear, fresh, and vivacious apple scent. It will certainly also. It will go. It is quite good.
Yes.
That's a good one. So then we have...
that might be it, but he always manages to get out of it. It smells different now, sadly. It's saffron, but nice like this. That's not possible, I fear. This matter isn't related to the situation anymore, you see. Smells good. That smells like a mix of all three. There's definitely some sweetness in it. Might have to test that one again, but I think I'm leaning towards that side. So here we have our molecular scent. We've had this in development before.
Yes, good.
You can also create the molecular scent. It's designed to simply blend with all fragrances. It's quite similar to Molecule 01, just a bit different in essence. I've chosen a very personal scent exclusively for myself. Okay, folks, so I'd say let's go through with it. And then, let's wind down. And try for the driver. I've come up with a secret tactic. First off, there are a few gifts from me. And then I'll come around the corner with something. He won't see that coming. If you're looking to learn how to negotiate for a cause, please stay tuned. Where exactly have we ended up now? What sort of rides does he actually have here then?
Check this out. What is that? Who's supposed to buy all these cars?
Boy, quite the selection, huh? Intense, really. Later. I'm walking out of here with a new one, you know? That's the kind of thing it is. Should we bring the present now, you know, to start off on the right foot? You always have to remember this. It's tactic number one. If you want something from people, first you need to create a little door opener. A door opener, I believe, that costs 1,200 euros. But I'll get that money back right away. It's all strategy. Remember, if you come to me for things like that, what can one say when I'm about to negotiate? You can't say anything. Perfume, everything included, you know? That's the one. Are you speechless?
Really? Good, I'm done shooting the video. Want me to take something off your hands?
I brought you something.
Awesome, thank you. The camera's already running, I see. Ambush style. Ambush style.
Got that with you too? Yes.
Awesome. Got anything else? Maybe the car. Kind of a walking store. Welcome, first of all. Dude.
What kind of stuff do you have here, man? What kind of cars are these? This is insane.
Yes, exactly. That's precisely the whole idea. We very carefully and precisely drove the processor right into its place.
And what do you say? Does it work like this? Well, Hamid warned me. Hamid said I should be careful. I ordered one, but it's not arriving until 2:26 a.m.
Yeah. Alright, let me put it this way. At the moment, I'm addressing this too. Right now, we're incredibly outsmarted. I find that completely absurd.
But true, it's already fallen.
Yes, well, I still get... With three calls, I still get 900,000 euros gross for such a car. Yeah, actually...
Okay.
Wild. So I understand that, but still find it completely absurd. There are individuals who pay. Personally, I wouldn't pay. But I also think I'm actually also actively asking the question. It's listed at more than 500,000. The luxury car is listed at 330,000. And what do you personally say?
It was driven to death. You see it everywhere, you know. That's why it's kind of, yeah.
But the last one
that I happened to pick up on, yes, was somehow right around 650 in sales. Yes.
I can sell them for a lot more money. What you are able to do with watches, I can easily do with cars. No, I must say the porous sangue is really cool, of course. Its design, which really bugs me. Marc, when you look, I find the Biscot B-pillar pretty awesome. Yes, indeed. After that, it somewhat seems like an unfinished birth, really.
Okay.
He is actually 20 centimeters shorter than you thought. Wow.
I wanted the car for Victoria, for my wife.
That's super cool indeed. Please, take a seat. I've adjusted the front seat according to my size. You are 1.90 meters tall, right?
Yes.
Brief.
That's quite tight.
Close the door electrically, will you? Not like that, right?
So the back is actually really quite tight?
I'd say, in my current video presentation, Ferrari insists quite firmly that it is definitely not an SUV. But the car has four doors, and I think the car is definitely aimed at attracting customers from over here too. So, if you build a car with four doors, then stand by it, finish it consistently, and say, we've built an SUV. But this, I build an SUV, but don't say it's an SUV because I don't want to be uncool 6 years later, doing what others did 6 years ago.
Look, he's taking hard shots at Thingy, right? You're noticing that, aren't you?
Not really, but I'm so mad at them. I think Ferrari makes awesome cars, right? Gorgeous cars, right? Up to the 812, right? So everything that began with the 458 at some point, California, 458, 488, then the Pista, the 458 Special, all awesome cars, the 812, 812 4TS, 812 Competizione, F12 TDF, all mega cars, and then they started making rubbish again. So, 296, SF90, Roma Spider, yes, However, you might also tell, since these specific cars aren't really in high demand currently.
You've been sent the comprehensive lists for all the Ferrari models over these years.
Even for the F8, you managed to get it above list price, the 296 below list, the SF90 far below list.
So the tailor-made slot failed?
Which one do you mean?
296?
296? GTB or GTS? Coupe or convertible? Convertible. Convertible? If the car were here right now, would you still be able to add options? So 10% in options, is the car worth it? You surely wouldn't want to sell it right away. But the car would be worth 10% above list if it were available now. If the car arrives in a year, it'll be at list price.
Just for fun anyway, yes.
But these particular hybrid kinds of things and such aren't really quite popular with Ferrari at this moment. They're doing no one a favor. This is now a new generation that's been ushered in. Things aren't going well in many areas, and I believe this is the best example of things not going well.
But as you can see, the price is quite different.
Ridiculously expensive. Where's the justification for the car being pricier than an SF90 or an 8112?
That's the trend right now, just like with Richard May.
Cash in. People are evidently willing to pay a bit more. Thus, we should seize the opportunity and grab it ourselves before the secondary market does, right? But I'm so angry because I was looking forward to the car. And then... The car has many cool features, the interior as well. Let me show you something else. We've got a passenger display here. It's the largest, most awesome passenger display you can imagine. We've got an SUV here. Yes, an SUV. There are also kids in the back who then want to look at the front. Actually, it's not a passenger display. It's really just a display that was here at some point, always with Alba.
Okay, they moved it over.
They just moved it over. At some point, they started making passenger displays. It was a small, narrow display. From it, he got cool information either about sports cars or passengers. It has all gone overboard in terms of entertainment now. At first glance, you say, hey, a game, large passenger display. But on second thought, you wonder, why is this here and not in the middle?
Yes, indeed, that is quite a very valid point. Yeah, okay, I agree.
So, I am currently sitting in the car. It's kind of like, you know, I just picked it up early this morning.
I drove it myself to get to know the car.
So, I had my very first date, actually. Okay. And I just experienced my very first date with the car, and I'm so incredibly mad after the date.
I really hope you get into a much better mood.
Yes, now that you're here and all. I was totally confused earlier. I was on the phone with Marc, and then he was like, he'll come around 1:30 p.m. Then I was like to him, Marc, should I order you lunch? Then he goes and says, no, it's Ramadan. And I'm like, did he actually really just say that out loud? After that, it was like, okay, see you soon. And I was just ice cold on the phone. First it was like, yeah, okay, see you soon. Actually, I'm a born Muslim, but I don't practice it actively. And then Marc says to me, it's Ramadan, give me a quick rundown, please.
I converted in 2016.
Okay. For faith reasons, for marriage reasons, no?
No, my wife is Russian.
Okay.
I have been with her for exactly 10 years now, but yeah.
It was simply out of conviction. Respect. So it was such an answer I totally didn't see coming.
Till next time.
Yes, I must say, I have a lot of discipline and willpower.
That's something I can't manage. Anyway, let's get back to the car. Review. I'm still kind of like, they really want to sell an SUV, they just slapped four doors on it, didn't they? Now, let's look at the trunk, which is not too large. I will proceed to remove this. So, if you made the decision right now to close this lid, it would indeed be quite snug and tight around me. But also here. Now we're crossing back. Now let's sit here for a moment.
Yes, well, that's a different story. How many centimeters are we missing from the total length?
20. 20 centimeters can truly make a significant difference in our lives. And look right here. This is precisely where I was able to relax quite comfortably.
That's quite a different story.
I'm just setting everything up in such a really crappy manner. I see that too, with the hotspot constantly all the time. Where I'm thinking, folks, what's going on? We'll get to the interior in a moment. We'll be carrying out a sound check in just a short moment too. Perhaps we will indeed have to manage that situation. Quite big, isn't it?
Yes. But it looks good. Do you think the 23-inch wheels on the Performante look bigger than the 23-inch on the... Yes, absolutely.
I wouldn't have thought they're the same size.
I never would have thought that would be the case. I'm truly not sure why, but I mean...
It does look a bit adventurous.
Fundamentally, as far as personal appearance is concerned, tastes can greatly vary. One person likes this, another likes that. There's no such thing as beautiful or not beautiful.
But that's a bit more gentlemanly than that.
It looks more brutal, it looks finer. But when I first saw the car from that year, at the official presentation, I'm standing there, the car is unveiled, I look at it and think to myself, oh crap, well they actually built a Mazda.
There was this comparison on the internet.
After that, many others noticed it too. And then there are these comparisons with the Mazda and the Ferrari. Of course, it's significantly more expensive, much more valuable, including aerodynamics and everything. But when spending billions at a critical point, about 50-60% done, it must dawn on you that you're constructing, in reality, a Mazda. I mean...
Let's just say not many of them are on the road right now.
Yes, absolutely.
That's a very exclusive car.
This morning, you find yourself at the helm of the most exclusive SUV available. Furthermore, you're piloting a Ferrari, a vehicle that is exceptionally exclusive in its own unique right. You own the latest advanced car. By its design, years stand between. This was built in a completely different decade than the vehicle.
True, all of this indeed appears to be a bit more compact. I mean, even Porsche is getting more compact.
Yes, so, Marc, could you give me your detailed judgment on the exterior now? A visual check? Is it the Urus or perhaps the Ferrari?
Well, I would most definitely be a Ferrari, you see. I would be Ferrari. But I would definitely be Ferrari.
For me, this is too much. The Urus is too aggressive, really. Okay, let's do one thing now, yeah? So, let's do a quick check, shall we? Ferrari or Urus? I'll count to three, and then we'll both point to the car we truly prefer, okay? Alright then. 1, 2, 3. Good. 1, 2, 1. Let us now proceed to move towards the interior. What do you say? Yeah, let's go. Come on, let's go. Now squat down behind the wheel. Yes.
The interior is all significantly more modern. I believe it's the same steering wheel, too. So, please look. For the very first time, I implore you, look at this truly unique and interesting shape.
Yes, very cool.
Triangle here.
Raumschiff.
Spaceship leather.
Feels like an alien spaceship. Looks really cool. Very futuristic, very modern. Okay, that's how I imagine a spaceship. I think so, yeah. Alright, let's start up the clock right now. Marc, you have exactly 60 seconds to adjust your lordosis. What's this? What is this odd item in the airplane seat bag?
Oh, I see, okay.
Exactly, time's already ticking. Lean forward, lean back.
Okay, hold on. Wait, you're doing this over the steering wheel for sure.
You go ahead, I'll be right there. I'm gonna get the next one in, broaden the circle.
Okay, how can you adjust this thing? Okay, that surely seems to be a somewhat tricky question.
Can I sit in the back? I have a chauffeur after all, don't worry.
Good day, Mr. Eberhofer. Please, can you now kindly take me to Burger King? How exactly are you feeling today? And yourself?
You were a solitary diner here, right? Marc, have you adjusted his lordosis yet or not? No, not yet. Marc has about 60 seconds, but I think he's well over time to adjust his lordosis. Look, I say this, and that's what bothered me. Do it via voice command. Via voice command.
Hey, Ferrari, so...
No, not Lamborghini, please. Phrase that precisely and ask again. Lamborghini starts up. Hey, Lamborghini, just imagine what the can support.
Okay, so I think, look, you say... One must tread new paths.
Yes, I'm rejoining you right now.
One would think it's over here on the left side. Yes, but why not reinvent things for once? Yes, of course, do you understand? Yes, and that's why... I'm sorry, I didn't get that.
We didn't get it either, inventing anew. And with surround...
Right? So, I truly believe, without any doubt, that all this work is being done directly on the computer here.
Yes, no.
That's not done on the computer.
I'll cut this short, yes.
Say.
No, go on.
Right through the panel.
Yes.
Alright, let's do it here.
Yes, let's do that.
Great feature, first off. Really cool, really great.
Especially while driving at a speed of 190. Or maybe it's 290? Yes, even that 290, actually.
Okay.
But you're really close. Here? Yes. Ah, right here it is.
There. Listen, that's much better. Yes.
On the comfortable seat, that's much, much better indeed. Once you figure out exactly how to do it, especially the seat massage feature in a Ferrari, it's quite literally awesome.
Great. Design's awesome. Marc, seen the interior?
I have. Good. How do you like the interior? I think the Voodoo is beautiful.
Well, it's definitely high-end. Yes, it's brand new. You can tell this car was built in a different decade. They did take their sweet time 6 years.
Look, sorry, but that's really no valid comparison. That is indeed quite fair.
This is the most beautiful Audi RSQ8 you could ever sit in. So this very one, if you're standing right next to it...
Just look at this.
Good.
I'm silent.
Good.
But not towards that one. If you give me the other point for the interior right away...
Then I don't get it.
Okay, let's leave it at that for now. Please take care of it.
May I ask for a seat test now?
And?
Now you have a chubby son. There's considerably more room here.
This is frightening now. Here comes the giant yellow. Yes, unbelievable. Is it because of the size? 20 centimeters longer for the Urus. Let's do a sound check. Okay.
Did I start it? Yes.
Still drive a daily. I am quite clever, you know. I said to myself, come on, I'll just get a budget Urus. I'm driving one that's 200,000 euros with 100,000 kilometers. It came with an Akrapovic system right from the factory, which now has 100,000 kilometers on it, so essentially you've got bare pipes. Okay, that certainly comes out quite differently, doesn't it now? Let's all go ahead and hear it over there, shall we?
Now, I am deeply intrigued. Now, I am really deeply intrigued. You've absolutely got to sell it too.
Already did.
That's why...
We're starting... Way more intense, and
that's way crazier,
man. Different,
but that's just
neither one of those individuals was performing particularly well at all.
Both were not good. Okay, I'm not familiar with this, honestly. I don't know much about it, but you say the Ferrari, tell me,
you've really got the hose properly on it. I genuinely don't understand why I'm having such significant trouble with the car today. I'm asking you now. You came to me. You said, hey, I need a car for my wife. Now, I've shown you both cars. 550,000, and we're just talking about list prices. 550,000, 340,000.
It's a matter of image.
Honestly, normally, most individuals likely call up their beloved wife to quickly come to the car. No, I see it differently. Yes, you are simple.
I am a sister.
Where exactly is the softer look located now?
Right here, 100%.
Gentlemen, perhaps a tad more everyday-like. A look. That's vicious. Truly vicious. You've let it rip in the end. Seldom has a car played like that. It's out of overdrive now, so... I'm on board.
But of course, price is definitely a factor.
Even if you're thinking you could buy that one and a Portofino, or just buy this one alone.
That is quite something, you know, I know.
And really smart if you're wobbling. Exactly.
From that perspective, it's natural, yes, but you've clearly positioned it with that, you know?
Yes, you've definitely positioned yourselves. They want to pay more. I believe the sales figures are there. They want to pay more. They don't want to build more than 3,000 units either. That's quite a cash cow for Lamborghini. So, there you have exclusivity in any case. You also have a more modern design here. Yes, you've also got 12 cylinders.
Driving behavior, so what exactly would you say about it?
Performance, well, I simply just didn't quite feel the true impactful power of those impressive 12 cylinders while I was actively driving. So, my critique would be, the steering wheel felt a bit too slim for my grip, because they've taken those sports car genes and placed a sports car steering wheel into the compact SUV. Didn't quite fit for me. Yes, I noticed that too.
That was a bit...
Exactly. But of course, you do indeed have an incredibly exclusive car. I must say, you are the proud owner of a very rare, limited edition vehicle. Here you have a unique situation at Lamborghini. They produce to earn money, produce to make a profit. Still, really cool, futuristic interior. I believe if someone says, I have two young children, or actually I don't have any young children and I just want to drive something like this, then you've got here the much more modern, much more exclusive car. You also have 12 cylinders, a dying breed, one must say. Here you've got 8 cylinders. If you need a bit more everyday utility, I believe this is the right car. If you just want to be modern, want to be exclusive, a very, very, very high ranking car dealer colleague of mine, someone I highly, highly value. I was talking to him about cars, then he said to me, listen, if you want to drive the best SUV in terms of price, value, performance, you buy a Cayenne Turbo GT. Okay. But if it's about having the image and everything, then you need to go for the Puro Sangue, not the Urus, because the Urus, everyone's driving it, we've all seen it, nobody has the Puro Sangue. I believe that's our conclusion. The bottom line is, I think...
You are. I'm definitely Team Puro Sangue, you too.
Lambo? Yes then. I'm off with Marcus now. You've done everything right with the car on your own. Initially, what began as a solo unexpectedly evolved into a trio. This change surprised us and added complexity and harmony, enriching the experience. This truly is absolutely the very finest and best, specifically when it relates directly to organizing very large and significant gatherings.
That was our detailed review. Once we had a call, and he then quoted me a price. The vehicle is situated right there up front. The second key is still present there. Winter tires are included as well.
Backstory, have you already gone ahead and shared that particular story with the camera?
I really desire the car, as we're relocating next Tuesday, and unfortunately, I can't transport the car with me on my own.
You're in the right spot.
Exactly, I called you. And the thing is, I'm a trader, he's a trader. And when you provide such a specific price indicator, then I really must say I was absolutely quite astonished. You probably expected there to be a bit of trading and such going on?
No, okay.
So I'll put it this way. We are going to do something else in a moment. But first, the price you shouted out to me, I must say.
Very fair.
Usually with car dealers, it's always quite a long and frustrating battle, really. I once sold a Porsche. I'm listening to you. There you are, finally, the price. And I know what one should earn.
I must say that's not me. I think I often give in during negotiations and purchasing. Because I'll just quickly meet with my supplier, my seller halfway, and then say to them, I will indeed pay you that amount. But I also firmly think, then he will definitely call me a second time. He told me the exact price, and you said you were approximately about where I wanted to go as well. I also told him I'd buy that thing for 210 because I can sell it for 230. Yes.
And when you look online, that's how it is.
That fits as well. I know the course is like the back of my hand. That's how it turned out. So we said, all right, let's take care of the rest on site. After all, I haven't seen him. I simply took you at your word, but that's the point. Look, just like you have a knack for watches. Like if someone shouts Rolex with such and such a code or Richard Mille, then you know the price right away. It's the same with me. I decide here, and as you know, we have many cars over there. It's on its way. Truly, I genuinely make decisions here in just a minute. I'm not sure if I should buy a car or not.
I've also packed everything up. I've got it all with me. This humido.
Cars, I already own some very cute little tiny slippers.
In Dubai, I actually watched some of your videos too.
Yes.
You've been on the road too.
Exactly. Absolutely. And always, for sure. Although I do indeed perform something I can swiftly show you right away. That's not at all common in Germany. I do have Jacob Co. watches, yes.
Could we see that?
Let's check it out, shall we? I'm really curious. It's quite trendy, isn't it?
Yeah, so Jacob and Co., we were also in Dubai not too long ago and stuff. The guys are super, super nice and they just do really unique roles. In today's world, where all do the same, they're breaking new ground.
This is unique.
Got one there?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, cool. Especially, I find it so awesome. I was once in Dubai with two really solid guys. Though they had a lot of money, then one comes up and says, I've got a PS Unique here. Yeah, then the other guy comes, I have one too, but they looked exactly the same.
No, there are minor differences then.
So they called Jacob right away, totally offended, and said, hey, you here. Then he goes, no, turn it around. And indeed, there were differences in detail on the backside. It's unique. In a way, actually, every car, except for Tesla, since they're really all the same, is essentially a one of one, if you look at it that way.
What do you say, General Portofino? What do you say, Portofino M?
Very cool.
I must say, at first, when I actually got my car back in those days, I was a bit like, yeah, it's okay, sort of, I guess. But by now, I must say, I find the car to be really practical for everyday use. Drive with the top down, people love the feedback.
You also have good performance.
You have good performance. Since I have the GT3S, naturally, in terms of road handling,
It's perfectly fine. You know, I actually really truly like the California Turbo quite a lot. I really enjoyed the last facelift of the California, thought it was very good. And the Portofino was practically yet another final facelift of the California. And I think it's very successful. Very beautiful. No keyless, right? Your car now, you can see, it has a matte paint protection film on it.
Exactly. I have such a thick PPF film. Actually, the car looks like this.
You had in between a sort of film-related mishap, visually speaking. What's that? That's mine.
You mean this? Well, we had three slides. This is the third variation. I'm ready to assist, but it seems there was a misunderstanding.
I once saw a video with lots of stripes on it.
Oh, right. Yes, my initial try. Aimed for a Tron design, I thought, so added that. Yes, Tron. Yes, after that we had...
That was for the Tron folks. After? Yes, well...
Now, I'd say it seems okay.
Right? Yes, no, so go ahead. That looks really cool.
Such a stripe.
Ah, I'm seeing this for the very first time. Do you actually have one? You opted for a matte, so it's a very matte finish with some quite striking metallic stripes on it. I think I'm going to bottle it. Yeah, okay. The concept is very cool, indeed. No, the beauty of it, you say?
Is, I've kept all interesting things, never mentioned that, did you? My sales consultant always said those are the important things that people pay attention to. Look at all the stuff I got, all the things I still have with me. First off, the car in a rather miniature version looks amazing. Super cool, right? Yes, this has to mean something, right? So then I've got this here with this key thing.
Yes.
Does that mean nothing at all, or does it mean nothing to you?
I'm asking you the other way around.
With me, somehow?
No, if you now wanted to buy a used car from me... Yes. Yes, and you know very well the market price of the car is 230,000 euros. Yes.
Yes. And then I come around the corner and say, Marc, listen, the previous owner took such good care of the car.
Yes, but refurbished, they look same. Yes, but its last owner maintained it well. Look, I still have the toy car, and here I have a box, and in there I have another toy car. And then I have another toy car. Would Marc Gebauer say, oh, it's really cool that it's such a role model?
You can't ask Marc Gebauer. Maybe just someone general.
Exactly, I don't care. No. I don't care means the buyer won't appreciate that from me later on. The buyer wants a respectable car from a reputable previous owner, well maintained.
We do have that. That you've now kept the watch box, that annoys you.
But if you hadn't given me the toy car, it wouldn't have been a big deal either. I decided to go ahead and do it anyway. No, I genuinely truly appreciate that.
And look what else came with it. I'm not sure what it's for, but we've got this bag here as well.
Yes, awesome. I'm taking that too. You also have a DVD changer.
Yes, it's been a while.
No, but nice car though. By the way, here at Ferrari, you always get a good look at the features. The first thing I always look at quickly, does it come with an elevator? E-lift? Well, that too. I've never needed it. That's what they always say. Whenever they decide to sell you a car without a lift, they always say...
With the GT3, okay, but with those, you need it anyway.
But when they buy a car with a lift, I mean, if they buy a car and you say, oh, it doesn't have a lift, that's terribly frowned upon at B-Dive.
When I say you don't want to spend steering wheel.
Yes, steering wheel, not LED one.
But I think it works in this car. You know, it's kind of a cruiser too. Yes, never mind.
No lift. I don't need it in my daily life. A lift system. But many insist on it. For many, it's a no-go. For many, it's a deal-breaker.
I'm trying to explain to the car salesman.
We've got ADAS fuel pack in there. All good. Passenger display. We've got surround view included. That's important. Do we have the sound system in it? What do we have in there? JBL is currently plugged in and ready. Good. You are doing an exceptionally fine job driving safely today. Yes, I am taking off everything that's specifically related to the foil, okay? It simply doesn't suit the car at all. The Ferrari, look, I think the paint, it must be Rosso Corsa. Exactly, that's just beautiful. Yes, it's beautiful. Although, when you open the doors, it's a bit puzzling. Then, I would have wrapped the door sills. Though, I didn't do it on my gurus.
I wrapped that one too. I just wanted it cheap. I can tell.
We are quite alike.
No, I think you have a very, very elegant car. It's got such an elegant vibe to it.
It's kind of undercut by that stripe and all that stuff. The base vehicle is gigantic, the previous owner prominent. It doesn't get any better than this.
Well, otherwise I'll search.
Please have a look through.
Marc wanted to come 2 days ago already.
Yes, the car was empty. I have no idea why, because normally it always lasted, and now it's run out once.
So with Ferrari, there's this rule of thumb. If it's parked, it's charging. So the cars... We often ask about them in our videos too.
But honestly, it has held up quite well. I've experienced no trouble over these past 2 years.
Are all the aero lights now turned off?
I haven't turned it on now.
Defect. Engine control system. Workshop alert.
otherwise very cool. I'll take it for 210.
Yes.
I have one more aspect to discuss. Negotiating is part of it indeed, but it's a different ride altogether. Actually, we're currently building a public school in Kenya. You'll get a fully deductible invoice. Now it's up to you to say, would you like to contribute something more? We'll keep the purchase price as it is, but would you like to contribute something more?
You're buying for 210,000, then I'll donate 2,110 euros. Thank you. Thank you so much. Marc, with every euro you knock off the price and seal the deal, I'll donate it in the end. That means, if you say now, I'm not selling it to you for 210, but for 205, I'll also donate the 5,000 euros. Yes, I believe you, but then I could just donate and deduct them myself.
Awesome.
And then you might also vividly remember when I had personally handed it over to you.
Yes, we're calculating. Very, very cool. I must say, I was really amazed that you were so fair to say something right away.
No, come on now, really. I'm always in. Oh, is that one wrapped up as well?
Oh, yes.
It's also laminated. I thought that was a two-tone objection. Well, now you've got the handshake. Could I take it inside for a detailed inspection? Yes, please. The mechanics need to closely look at the engine warning light to fully understand the issue at hand. Yes, besides, we always have the absolute top-notch items inside. You know, we don't do second-rate goods. So, that's basically triple A, double A, and A. And then, just over there, we have that all the way. Back there is a professional photo frame. Oh, okay. With extra lighting and everything included.
What's your view on Porsches?
There came an awesome car. If you get one, really, really awesome. It was. I personally drove it, then made a comprehensive video on it, and illustrated quite diligently. The way whether you get one, and if you do get one.
I've seen that video.
Did I get into trouble for it? Yes.
I believe you. He definitely takes shots at everyone. He knows no bounds. So you don't care, you just go off on everyone. You know, it's like this, because you're also a grey market dealer, one could say.
Yes, I'm a free trader, I'm a free man. Exactly. I'll tell you something, actually, I've got reactions to it too. I did indeed point out that if you happen to desire to order a Dakar, the Porsche Center always asks, precisely how many cars did you actually purchase from us in the last year? Okay.
But don't you get it? You've got to, you know...
The best clients, really. Wait. Then? They say, okay, how many cars have you bought? Okay. Fair, you've got to... Then they say, wait, if you now want a GT3 RS and a Dakar, or if you, I don't know, soon want a GT2 RS, a Sport Classic, whatever. Yes, then be so kind and buy your wife a Macan as well, and better yet, a Taycan, all right? Then you go, yes, okay, you're taking it, right? Ideally, you are a very loyal, dear customer who simply doesn't resell the car. But at the very same time, they saddle you with exactly two more cars, where you'll most definitely lose quite a substantial amount of money. They know that too. And you're not supposed to resell it, so you don't benefit from the car's increase in value. Then you say, okay, I'll also buy a Macan, a Panamera, and a Taycan on top of that. Then they say, that's great, here's a Porsche watch as well.
I really have to say, Porsche in Dortmund certainly didn't do that.
Pretty awesome. I've got 6 watches in my safe. Shout out to... No. You know?
Do you know why that happened? Do you know why the Porsche guys got as much commission for the watch as they did for the car plus minis?
Yes, so one or the other also bought a bicycle.
Oh, quite impressive indeed, I must say. I've seen that before as well.
So, Porsche Center Dortmund, I know it. Holzwickeder, right?
Look at this. Seen the new concept?
No, not at all. Quite
really cool.
So, I know the guys as well. I have to say, I really like Porsche Center Dortmund a lot, but also many other Porsche centers. I work at Porsche Center Mannheim, Germany. Porsche Center Mannheim has really good guys. I've heard that too. Porsche Center Saarland, where my very good friend Florian Ditzler is, also great guys. I can also understand when the guys say, hey, you really could have saved on that video. Because then they don't say my friends, but in general they say, okay, you've already bought cars from us. Now purchasing 2 cars and adding a watch to it. Then you get the car now. That's great, but please, no bank transfer. Sign up for financing or leasing.
That buys... They want to make sure you don't sell it.
But it is actually a closely linked product. Such products are not allowed.
You have to say that is...
It has unfortunately become a somewhat common practice, which is not allowed. That is precisely why I felt compelled to create and share a video, which, to my disappointment, some found disagreeable.
So I ended up calling it Porsche Mafia. Yes.
You're not afraid of anyone, huh?
No, it's not the Mafia, I just wanted to point that out. Because, I mean, we've got such an awesome company with Porsche.
We build such awesome cars. Quality-wise, emotionally, it's a German product.
Everything is absolutely perfect.
But to reach this point in such a manner, very recently, is rather unsettling. That's precisely what the Italians always do. Do you want to actually become Italians? Today, I'm making a video for you.
Today, things heat up?
I'm telling you, my dear friends, I really like all my Italian companions, and I profoundly love Italy. What I mean by that, these are basically structures, previously known from the Italian traders, where goods were much, much, much more exclusive, and the fight for them was quite different. Following that, some Porsche centers said, hey, we don't like this, we don't want to do business with you.
No.
Wait, then I looked around and counted my Porsches. Was I like that? Well, it's not so bad.
But it's precisely this video. So many Porsche customers have messaged me. Porsche customers who have really big collections.
Finally, someone said it. Finally, someone is really doing it. And now we just really want to be your customers.
I do get that. It's the same with watches, really. With watches, especially with Patek and Nautilus and the like, there are always these connections involved. And the fact that people get upset about it, I do understand.
I'll show you. What catches your eye here?
So, I'll be honest with you. By saying now, not that my first car will be in America, but a Rolls Royce would be a car I'd love to drive someday in the future.
Cullinan, right?
Where do you see me? I think more like a Cullinan.
I see you in a Cullinan? Yes, yes, Cullinan. But I see you much more in this Rolls Royce Wraith Mansory I have here, with Tiffany colored leather.
Explain Mansory for the people, because we've never really covered it. Mansory is a customizer.
Yes, Mansory is a customizer. I'd also say globally the most expensive one.
Indeed. Yes, so that's really top-notch, top-notch. Mansory does some really, really extreme modifications.
So, a refinement like that, actually, it starts at 150,000 and really goes up to no limit at all. So, you can do anything. Mansory, for instance, turned a Lamborghini Urus into a coupe.
So, there's Mansory, there's Brabus, there's Haiwani, or what on earth is it actually called, maybe? Could someone remind me? I'm not quite certain. There happens to be another distinct brand as well.
Mansory is genuinely considered to be the ultimate, very pinnacle of decadence, refinement, unparalleled and opulent luxury, coupled with an abundance of zeal and fervor. We've got here a Rolls-Royce Ray as a Blackbird. The base vehicle alone costs 350,000 euros used. And then it got the full makeover here. When you see this, you notice the slats, which are double layered.
Very nice.
Really great, really great. It even has lighting in the cars. But when you say, for instance, most people claim we don't have a warranty here.
Yes.
It depends on what. So if you put on a body kit without changing the engine or anything, then you still have warranty. And now let's open this up here. I'll do the stitching. Yes, exactly. Pretty awesome, right? Incredible.
And this elegant black piece, it's actually an authentic original from Tiffany's. Do you know what that signifies? And what a splendid carpet this is indeed.
Oh my dear, incredible glamour. Do you know exactly how many lambs must tragically die for such a doormat? None, my dear friend. The lambs are just freshly sheared, you understand? I really, truly have got to say.
The video takes a twist. Do you enjoy such things? Yes.
Are you considered the sporty type? No, not really at all. I mean, I absolutely love the experience of driving the Rolls-Royce Array. Driven for years, many, various, always swapped. Me, as a dealer?
You can search too.
What you drive. And, that car, you don't drive it every day. I made the mistake of driving it daily at some point. Then, the appeal of the car, that exclusivity, because no matter what you do on a daily basis, it just isn't the same anymore. Then, I left it parked for a while, then drove it again, and then the whole thing became... You're here. It doesn't get more luxurious than this. Right now, I'm having several Koenigseggs customized, both at Mansory and Novatec. I'm really eager for the result. Wow, it's taking things to a whole new level. It's for all those who say all my buddies are already driving Rolls-Royces.
You need something more unique, exactly.
And then you move towards personalization, customization. Here, a completely new exhaust system is being fitted. Yes, indeed.
Well, that's quite interesting indeed. What's your opinion on price stability?
Yeah, it's okay. You're looking at a moderate depreciation over the next few years with the cars. Which is normal, of course. I mean, before Corona, before COVID. With the cars, you buy a car, it's worth less a year later. It was worth less even 6 months later, except for various special vehicles, special models. But the fact that any random car suddenly became more valuable, that was an effect we saw from COVID. Money was cheap, supply was
scarce, there were no new cars, that's why it went up!
Now, it's all coming down again. It's normalizing again, it already has normalized.
Market rates are at new prices now, but back to an old level, just like watches.
Prices at 2.19 euros.
Exactly. Yes, and that's where we are now, which is good because we're 5 years past 2019 and we're at the price level of 2019.
That means over 5 years. You haven't had any depreciation at least.
And if you sold at the right time, you made an incredible amount of money.
Absolutely.
And now, everything's going back to normal. Sometimes customers reach out to me saying, I'd like a car that doesn't lose value. I'm like, me too.
Yes. On a very precise and specific price level, so your investment isn't situated within the typically high and daunting several hundreds of thousands range, but rather, it is precisely and very strategically positioned at a significantly more accessible and reasonable figure, exactly 150,000. Exactly.
And considering that,
it's only developing very moderately downwards. With other manufacturers, you end up having drastic price drops. But if you look, for example, at the Lamborghini Urus, if you ordered a Lamborghini Urus in 2019, drove the car for 50,000 kilometers, you could still get easily 230,000 euros for the vehicle today. Originally, the car cost 250,000 euros.
Solid.
Yes.
Stable.
So, it's been coming along pretty well, but that's a car for you.
I feel like I have to say, you'll find out in the video. You'll find out when you're there too. Yes.
That would be almost good, of course. What do you think of the manhole cover, Rene?
I have actually just seen that. This doesn't really spin at all, does it?
It always stays level. So the Mansory logo and the original Rolls-Royce, the logo always remains upright.
Quite something, isn't it? Truly very extravagant indeed. The guys really went all out on this, even with the detailed painting here.
And the coach line, hand-drawn.
Quite impressive, huh? And 500 million must be covered here.
Tax ID, yeah, all right. Otherwise, this is actually a brand new, incredible Aston Martin Valkyrie model.
It's essentially considered a myth in reality. You scarcely ever see one, do you? Have you ever had the chance to drive it yourself?
No, just moved it around here on the premises. But the car has factory miles, never been driven, and we won't drive it either. That is something that's solely for the final owner to do.
But do you still feel something when you buy a car like that? You do, right? As a dealer, are you still there?
Feeling can be tough. I feel quite a bit when I've sold him, making a lot of money. Yes, okay. Then I do feel something, yes. But no, I love the product, and I think I also have one of the coolest products, similar to you, because whoever is our customer has achieved something, they want to reward themselves.
They come with purely positive emotions. No one comes to you and says, hey, my Casio broke, I just need a Richard Mille now.
But there's someone who says, hey, today's the day. Exactly, and it's the same thing here. No matter who, no matter the industry, everyone ends up with the cars. And everyone has emotions for cars.
Exactly, so...
So where are we at practically? 3.6 million. Oh, okay. That's actually quite good, considering there are 6 million next to you.
I think I saw a video on that recently too. Yeah, there was a collector from Kitzeldorf or something who had one of those. Cologne?
Cologne? The Marcus? Marcus Zion. It's his car as well. Really? Okay.
Okay, I don't know him, but I've watched his videos. Yes?
That also came from Marcus Jung.
What an absolutely stunning sight. That is certainly on a completely next level.
The interior has this past future vibe. I mean, it looks futuristic and at the same time...
Yes, classic. Yes, that's natural then, but I believe he also said in a video... Regarding the future perspective, it's one of the rarest cars ever.
The car will definitely, in a few years, right now 6 million euros, and looking ahead, 10 million euros in 10 years, are absolutely possible. When you look at it from the back, it's got a bit of a spaceship vibe. It reminds me so much of Alien, the Alien movie series.
Quite impressive, really. When was the car built?
2019, all right then. What exactly was the list price? For those particular cars, it was 4 million.
Okay, then you've got to be ready to fork out 2.19 euros just like that.
Okay.
2020, okay, here's road approval.
This right here is something very, 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 very special. So we've got a McLaren Senna, just like the blue one over there. Yes, all right, there are exactly 500 Sennas. Road legal. And then they constructed a McLaren Senna GTR, of which there are only 75. Let's start here. This is the chassis number. 01. It's the 01 out of 75 McLaren Senna GTRs.
It is indeed on the plaque and also in the VIN as well.
And then, the car received a Lanzante conversion. Only 8 cars worldwide have received the Lanzante conversion.
Lanzante is McLaren in Greece, and they then convert the vehicle for just about 400,000 euros, so that it gets a road operation permit.
A road traffic authorization, which also involves the process of procuring a license plate light at the rear end.
Yes. Okay. Yes, I've got chassis number 0175 here, and I have the Lanzang Zoom engine in the vehicle. I'm imagining.
You're now tearing down the street with it.
Already did it.
Yeah? And feedback? People just can't believe what they're seeing, right?
Insane. So, on the highway, everyone was like this. 2.5 million. Not too bad, right? Really, really intense. Yeah, that's us.
Where are the watches?
Should I? Yes, fetch the watches. Got the watches here. Really? Yes, yes, fused together. Take this with you. This is where the vendors are locked up. Yes, that too. Here we also sit with friends, with customers. It gets a bit more comfortable, I'd say. Shall we start with the expensive one or the cheap one?
First, show me the one that's affordable.
I currently own a Jacob Comrade Epic X Chrono. Last year I experienced such a strange orange craze.
Yes.
Okay.
Epic X is indeed a very, very large watch. Is it ceramic or? I think it's ceramic. Yes, so it's the chronograph.
The advantage here is...
The watch isn't too pricey, but features late configuration. Yes?
I have got a quite very thin wrist. Very thin. Indeed quite sleek.
The watch is 45 mil.
Yes, indeed, and it is much like the everyday casual wear from Jacob. It's essentially considered the Rolex of Jacob Co. Yes, and the watch is very sporty.
Where from?
From Dubai. Ah, okay. So, I ordered it in Dubai along with the other watch.
But we received it in Switzerland. And then, the usual procedure followed.
We even filmed it in the video. I can also...
I think, remember that you mean us?
Pick up and... Right, then we did order 2 Bugatti watches and they're there. And then we took the Bugatti to Jacob Co. in Switzerland to pick up the Bugatti watches. And then we flew them out, the watches that is at customs in Switzerland. Then again in Germany at airport customs we could even film there.
Oh. In Frankfurt?
Yes, okay. And yes, the watch. Where do you estimate its price range?
I did say they're quite unique at FX. But it's like that, or generally with Jacob Co. should each be considered as a separate unique case.
Every watch is...
And resale it is, mostly. Nowadays everyone wants the same thing. What did the list cost?
35.
Ah, okay, that's alright though.
That works, I think.
Yeah, it really does. Did you pay 35? No. No, okay, okay, okay.
No, I actually think that in this specific case, it's perfectly okay.
For that, you've got to say, it's okay. For that, one can, one can.
We had a really cool deal with Jacob. Yes. It was such a thing in my life. The background was, you know, we are dealers. And then, as dealers, we drive a Bugatti ourselves. Of course, we own the car, see it as a very valuable and important investment, but when the appropriate time comes, we inevitably sell it too. Then we go to Bugatti meets. There, you're nothing special, you're not special anyway, but you're not specifically special if you drive a Bugatti, because everyone drives a Bugatti.
Yeah, there. So you get out of the car, and everyone immediately starts gawking at you.
That's where their second glance goes, right? Because everyone has a Bugatti. Yes. And that day, I swore to myself, before I show up there next time with a Rolex or with a...
Left no moped.
Yes, when I decide to go there with an AP, I prefer to wear my Apple Watch. Okay? Yes. Because they look down on you. Like, oh, could afford the lease rate for the Bugatti, but not anymore for the watch. And then we thought, okay, what do? We obviously wanted watches. That would make us stand out in conversation, something more exclusive, something that would make us noticeable, etc. And then the first idea that comes to mind is Patek.
With Patek, you must be careful.
You really need the very expensive one. Yes, Richard Miller. RM would have been a good fit. RM fits quite well indeed. Are you interested? Just say the word, for I have a thoroughly prepared opinion ready for you. You often see the RM, you see it prominently displayed among all sorts of diverse individuals across many places. And its image has become somewhat fuzzy.
Yes, so it depends on which watch you choose, but wait, for them to be price stable and so on, Richard Mille...
is indeed a quality product.
And in the car segment, what do you associate with Richard Mille?
With McLaren.
With McLaren and partly with Ferrari.
Now it's flattening, but that's just a verdict.
So, as Bugatti drivers, naturally, we didn't want to opt for the McLaren.
Then I walked past the Jacob from the store in Dubai at the Dubai Mall.
But, just like an eager window shopper, much like a small excited kid, when I saw the prices, I had to forget it. Then my buddy goes, come on, let's go in, just to take a look. And that's how it all started. Then the salesman caught me, and next thing you know, we ordered them.
Then we had already ordered the watches. I'll tell you all about it in just a moment.
Let's first take a look at the watches. We have a beautiful carbon box. I believe the collaboration came about in 2000 and during Corona, around 2020 or so. Before that instance, it was in collaboration with Parmigiani. Bugatti had introduced Parmigiani watches to the marketplace.
Oh, wow.
Check this out. Ceramic cases. With orange too. Did he make those especially for you? Yeah.
A one of one, pièce unique. I've got the white band for the watch, and I've got an orange band too. So I really enjoyed wearing it with the orange band. As I mentioned, I was on this orange kick. Totally delicious too.
One might even say, it is indeed a genuine masterpiece. Just simply a masterpiece.
Can I make it a bit wider?
No, no, it's fine. Intense.
You got the V16 in there? Yes.
It's a brilliant sapphire block, right? And you can actually activate it, can't you? Have you fully wound up the watch yet?
I'll do that for you. You see, I must say, you really need to be careful with that watch. Just like you say, you're wearing a masterpiece on your wrist, but you also tend to knock it around a bit. Yes, indeed, you can certainly begin your work right here and now.
Then the engine starts.
Then the 16-cylinder fires up. Yeah, intense. You've got 4 shock absorbers.
For the factory mount.
Exactly. So, essentially, if you look at it now, you'll need to recognize this is the vehicle's silhouette. This is the back. Right here, we have this ellipse that the Bugatti possesses.
Yes. On the side, you can also recognize the shape here. This is the front with the horseshoe grille at Bugatti.
And this is the back of the watch. And I wore it for a very long time with an orange stripe. And,
must have gotten some crazy feedback on that.
Yeah. A lot of people thought the watches would be adored. Jacob in the goal, they don't lend you watches. Jacob Arabo.
He's part of all that's related.
Yes, a distinguished businessman.
You can't pull that off with him.
He does a good job too. You go into his store. Actually, they sold me the watches just like that. I was in their store, the salesman advised me. Then, I also left a deposit with him. Actually, it's about 2 watches. Then, I was just about to fly back. Then, they suddenly called me. Yes, it's us here from Jacob Co. And are you still in Dubai? I was like, yes.
Yes, actually, Mr. Jacob would really like to meet with you. And then I was like, exactly which Mr. Jacob?
And they were like, you idiot. Which Mr. Jacob? Mr. Jacob would like to meet you.
And I was like, he wants to meet me? Is he serious about wanting to meet me?
He wants to see her. Heard the story, the whole thing, about what it's about, and he'd like to talk in person. And until that day, buying watches was way too expensive for me, according to Jacob. I won't do that. Then you go into the store, Mr. Jacob shows up, grabs you for a personal meeting. Then he truly goes old school, sits behind his desk, and starts talking to you. And then, he's got you.
Then you gotta buy?
Yes, then he's got you. Yeah, and that's how I ended up with the watch. Cool.
List? What's the list?
List for 50,000 euros. Which means we're actually working at the lowest price range for a Bugatti watch.
Yes, so if we take these sapphire cases, or generally with embellishments. But here, the initial price is also important. It's crucial to position ourselves at the lower end. That's definitely important.
Mine too, of course.
But I honestly believe that the watch suits you too, my friend. You can certainly pull it off with style. I think that it looks already...
Looks quite easy. I'd assume it'd be very heavy.
Looks quite light though. But that's an investment for us too.
Just as we choose to invest in a car, we also decide to put our money into a watch.
Yes, right. You've turned it into more than just buying a watch. Yes?
That's quite an interesting story right there. And regarding the watch, I'm patiently waiting for the perfect buyer to come along.
So, if you want to buy the watch, contact Marc, the watch dealer of your balcony. Exactly.
Wir machen es möglich.
Yes, you've had a wait too. And I believe we've now also finished production.
I sincerely believe this particular version should, at this point, now be fully ready.
Exactly.
I believe there's always some new stuff coming, but that should be finished for now.
Exactly, and then we'll see. With Jacob, they really push the envelope in terms of marketing. They truly love being seen with famous stars. Rihanna proudly wears it, Jay-Z too, Cristiano Ronaldo confidently sports it, and Conor McGregor, Literally, all are seen wearing Jacob & Co.
In America, they have an even more pronounced presence. How come?
That in Germany, Jacob & Co. is practically unknown?
Great. The German wants to buy a product today that he can sell tomorrow for more. Even more so with watches than with cars, indeed. And Jacob & Co., without a doubt, is considered quite a niche brand, truly. And there, it's just tougher. With such watches, and generally expensive ones, are damaged watches, just in revelry. That's what Germans are for. It's such products are tricky. When it was a boom market, when all prices were going up, then you could actually sell something like that. But otherwise, it really has to be quite tough. I might know about 5-6 people who would willingly buy a Richard Mille for $500,000.
Not more than that.
And in America or in Dubai, you've got way, way more people.
We do have two pieces. The black one is actually already sold.
The black one is sold, and the white one is still looking for a buyer. I've worn them now. I've had them. The problem is, I've also sold my Bugatti now. All right, I have completely made up my mind now. I will either sell the watch right now, or I shall go ahead and commit to buying back that incredibly iconic Bugatti.
Looking for something new in watches?
What do you suggest then?
Actually?
So, if you discount the watch and take it, I'll buy it. That's right. Thanks.
So that is indeed very much marketed quite differently, isn't it? Yes.
I wouldn't say that.
But do you have another watch?
Yes, yes, yes.
Batek or Rolex?
Neither of those. Okay, maybe in the next video then. So, actually, it's true, we take clocks also in figures on cars. Really? Yes, okay.
So, dynamic business model, you make everything possible.
Yeah, sure. We frequently have clients come in saying, hey, I'm currently short 20,000 in cash. For the price of the XY, you'll also take a watch. Cool. And then, watches get appraised.
Watches are actually easy to handle too. You've got no maintenance costs and so on. You just need to make sure they work. And beyond that, you can estimate the price, give or take.
In Dubai, they go further. In Dubai, they take watches, handbags, everything, including those payments. So, you see, if you, for instance, I was in Dubai at VIP Motors. They indeed have, on the very top floor, something very much like watches. There's a small, quaint watch boutique there, and experiencing it is quite intense.
Take the watch as a trade-in and I'll buy something from you. Let me do that near Germany. In America? Yes.
In Germany, it's a bit tough.
Is there anything else we might discuss?
I think we've pretty much covered everything, right?
Yes.
So, now you're likely wondering, where is Marc at this moment? That's indeed a very good question. Probably most of you. You've probably seen it on Instagram already. But if you want to know how the entire journey went, why I'm in pajamas, and what all went wrong on the way, how the cats are doing. How are you all? Tiziana, please come. Please just come. Come over here. Tiziana, just come over here. Tiziana, come. Where are you now? And how the cats made it through the journey.
Wow.
Then you'll have to tune into the next YouTube video coming up very, very soon within the next few days. Feel free to subscribe, leave a like, hit the bell, and you won't miss a thing. And in fact, we even have this amazing and fantastic giveaway from Las Vegas just for you guys. The next video is going to be really, really beautiful, and I'd be delighted if you guys would watch it.